this is what Covent Garden looks like at 5 in the morning.
Mm, and this is what I look like.
So fresh and beautiful.
Oh, that comes from taking a nap in the afternoon.
Covent Garden takes a nap? I wish we could get Pittsburgh to take a nap. Hell.
Hey, mind your backs. Ooh. Watch your plates.
Watch your what?
Plates. Plates of meat. Feet. It's Cockney rhyming slang.
Oh,
how about a really nice hot cup of rosy leaf?
A who?
Tea.
Oh, that'd be fine.
Okay.
Here, watch it!
Watch it. Sorry. Your dishes there.
Thank you.
I'll tell you about it sometime.
Oh, really?
Don't look now. There is a weirdo in a funny hat staring at you.
Where?
Open the heights.
Oh, him. Mm. That's not a weirdo. That's the ghost of Drury Lane.
He thinks he's a ghost? We got him on Hollywood Boulevard.
No. He's legitimate. According to legend, he's been sentenced to haunt Drury Lane forever or until he gives a good performance, whichever comes first. Would you like to meet him?
I'm not sure. He's not a weirdo?
No, he's genuine. If the ghost takes a liking to you, he'll let you run your hand right through him. He lets me do it all the time. Wait a minute. Sir, would you mind coming over here?
That was sensational. How did you do that?
Excellently, I thought. Good motto, Miss Andrews.
Hello.
Hi, I'm Dick Van Dyke.
I don't care.
Mr. Van Dyke is visiting from America.
How nice for America.
Oh, we're a little testy today. I think it'd be nice if you told our American friend a little of the history of Drury Lane and how you came to haunt it.
Again? Just 10 minutes ago, I told the whole story to a busload of stout women from Milwaukee.
Yes, but Dick is in show business, too.
Is he important?
Well, he has his own television show.
So has Flipper.
Well, Julie and I co-starred in a movie together.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, is that so? Well, perhaps I can tell the story once more today. The first Drury Lane Theater was built in 1663. I was a young actor at the time, making my debut as Laertes in Hamlet. I was very nervous. I remember seated in my dressing room. I had just opened a bottle of spirit gum. You do know what spirit gum is.
You use it to stick your beard on.
Very good, very good. As I was saying, I just opened my bottle of spirit gum when my dresser came in with a cup of mulled wine to calm my nerves. In my haste, I drank it in one gulp. Only it wasn't the mulled wine, it was...
The spirit gum.
I pasted my guts together and glued myself to death.
And ever since, the ghost has haunted Drury Lane, waiting for another chance to go on, no matter what the show may be.
Well, hang in there, fella.
We've done it all here, from grand opera to ballet to pantomime. You do know what pantomime is.
Well, you mean this kind of pantomime?
No, that's not what we mean by pantomime.
You mean the thing you do around Christmas time?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. You know, I've never seen one of those. What are they like?
Well, it's difficult to explain. It's sort of a traditional thing. How does one explain English pantomime to an American?
One doesn't.
Well, it's a little like vaudeville, and it's done in a fairy tale setting with a lot of audience participation.
Sound like an old Milton Berle show.
Yeah, only more so. It's a sort of hodgepodge of this and that and a lot of broad comedy. And the great fun is that the principal boy and the principal girl switch roles. That's what we call pantomime.
That's what we call women's lib.
My very favorite pantomime was performed in 1894. It was a version of Cinderella.
I've played Cinderella. I don't know anybody who doesn't love that story.
My ugly sister hated it.
Well, she would have loved this one. Once upon a time, a beautiful young girl named Cinderella lived in an old rundown castle with her two ugly sisters.
I'm always chasing rainbows, watching clouds drifting by. My schemes are just like all my dreams, ending in the sky. Some people look and find the sunshine, I always look and find the rain. Some people make a winning sometime, I never even make a game. Believe me, I'm always chasing rainbows, hoping to find a little blue.
Coming, sister dear.
Sister dear.
Yes.
Could I borrow some of your powder?
Help yourself, dearie.
Thank
you. Well, if you're going to fill those cracks in your face, you should need a 20-pound sack.
Sister dear, you're just jealous because the prince is having the first dance.
La da da da. The prince is having the first intermission with me.
You're going to laugh so much, you're going to get it. You know that. The prince is having the first intermission with you because he wants to currycomb his horse.
Why, it's getting foggy in here.
Oh, you're missing a little spot back there.
Oh, Cinderella, where have you been with my ball gown?
Sorry.
And where is my dress?
I have to finish ironing it.
Why, you?
Thank you.
Wishing will make it so. Just keep on wishing and troubles go.
Bye.
Oh, who are you?
Oh, I'm your fairy godmother.
You are?
Yes. Why am I here? Oh, yes, I thought you would like some company since your sisters have gone to the ball.
Oh, but that's what I wanted to do, fairy godmother. I wanted to go to the ball so badly.
Oh, you poor kid. Well, fear not. Cinderella, for your goodness and kindness and sweetness to all, tonight, Cinderella, you go to the ball. Yes, fetch me a pumpkin, four mice, and a rat. I'll make you a coach and a four horses and a footman and stuff like that.
But you know, for a godmother, you don't write very good poetry.
No, I don't. I know that. And my wand leaks. I'm so allergic to fairy dust, and I can't fly very well either, but I do my best, and I'm so honest. Go, my dear. Oh, absolutely.
The best that's hard to get these days, too. Oh, isn't that a shame? So straight as a dime, huh?
Here you are, fairy godmother.
Oh, my dear, I sent a pumpkin.
Well, I'm afraid it isn't very ripe.
Oh, really? Well, the coachman may be a little fresh, too, then. No humor there. Well, close your eyes, my dear. Count to three.
What?
Tap your toes together. Then make a wish. Okay, don't fail me now, sweetheart. Simsalabim!
Very good, Mother. Thank you.
It's the best I've ever done.
Oh, it's wonderful.
Beautiful. And now, come, my dear, and go to the ball. But remember, Cinderella, when midnight chimes, your gowns will turn to rags again, so you must be back.
Betimes?
That's very good. Now go to the ball and dance off both your shoes.
Oh, I will.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Oh, actually, you could drop me at the bottom of the garden. I have to kiss a frog.
Is that lovely stranger dancing with my good and trusted friend Dandini?
I've no idea, Your Highness.
Never mind. I shall meet her for myself.
Brighten your life with a few olives.
Ha ha ha. My poor.
Good morning, sister.
Must you speak so loudly, Cinderella?
I am commanded to search the kingdom high and low for the maiden whose tiny foot racing this slipper will enable his royal highness to visit. To claim his beloved and future wife. In other words, if this shoe fits, Muddo.
It's mine! It's mine! Tell the prince, if I live, the honeymoon will be in the south of France. Whichever's closest. It fits! Aha! It fits! Aha! It fits! Aha!
That's not a 90.
No. Give me that. It's my size. My perfect size. Just has to be eased a little. Here. I'll show you. This'll do it. That.
Give me. You need a glass bottom boat for that plate.
Well, it's glass. I don't suppose you would care to try the shoe on?
Oh, yes, sir, I would.
Very well, sit down. It's an exercise in futility. He told me to miss no one of the female gender. Marone. Your Royal Highness, come quick! Enough already!
Snow White?
You're not a dwarf. I'm in the wrong place.
Go fetch the prince.
The prince?
His Royal Highness.
I thought he was still a frog.
No, the one with the shoe fetish.
Oh, well done, Dandy. My princess.
Well, Din-Den Daily, my princess.
Hey, what do you think you're doing?
Dick, in English pantomime, the prince is always played by a girl.
Correction, until now.
Out of the question. It's tradition.
It's tradition.
Well, in that case, I'm starting a new tradition tonight, because if there's any kissing in this happy ending, I'm going to be in the thick of it.
Arise, my princess.
Good.
If I live to be 10,000, and I shall never forget the sound of the air raid siren. Whenever you heard that dreadful noise, you dropped whatever you were doing and headed for the nearest shelter. I'd been a dead around 300 years, and I don't mind admitting I was pretty scared. But it seems the more frightened we Londoners were, the louder we sang.
Marty,
darling.
It's early if you don't have to be back at the base at 5 in the morning.
Oh, don't go.
She'll show up any minute.
You're nothing. She's a great girl.
To be honest with you, as you have probably noticed, I'm a lousy singer. I've been sitting here so long, I'm dead from the waist down. And let's face it, Sue, she may be a great girl, but the chances of our hitting it off are 1 in 1,000,000 anyway. I think before I wreck everybody's evening, I better take off and get a few hours sleep on the train.
So what am I going to do with 2 girls?
You'll think of something. Believe that? Good night, Sue. Would you give my apologies, lady?
Hello. Got a soft mailbox on it.
Oh, you're not a soft mailbox. You're a hard lady.
What makes you think so?
Well, the last mailbox I passed didn't slap me.
Why are you so interested in mailboxes?
Well, to tell you the truth, I was hoping sooner or later to meet one that would direct me to Waterloo Station.
Well, on your present course, you'd be more likely to end up in the River Thames.
You know, I thought I was in the River Thames. This is the worst fog I've ever seen. You can't see anything.
Well, there you are.
There's one consolation.
Neither can the German bombers.
Well, yes, you're right about that. How long will this last, anyway?
Oh, it's hard to tell. With a real peace super, it could be hours.
Oh, no! Well, how am I going to get to Waterloo Station? You know, I'll miss my train. I have to be in Portsmouth at 0500.
You have to get back to your ship?
How'd you do that?
Well, you're obviously American, and Portsmouth is a naval base, and 0500 is hardly the time to go sightseeing, unless, of course, you're a clever German spy.
Don't be ridiculous. My name is Philly Jones. I am from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, U.S. of A.
Nice to meet you, Willie.
Now you will give me your name, Fraulein?
I'm Fred Smith. I'm a policeman, and you're under arrest.
You could have fooled me. You don't even feel like a policeman.
Well, I'm wearing one of our better disguises.
Is that so? Boy, if that's a disguise, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll give you $50 for it. I'll get back to the ship and make myself a fortune. Hey, the fog's lifting a little. Hey, you are a cop, aren't you? No, you're not. That's a uniform. You're a wren, a shipmate.
Well, I hate to disappoint you, Willie, but I've been in the Navy 2 years, and I haven't been within 100 yards of a ship.
Well, it's okay, Fred. I've been on a ship for 2 years, and I've never been within 100 yards of a beautiful wren. Say, listen, Fred, what we've got to do is forget about the past and concentrate on the present. As I always say, a bird in the hands is worth two in the bull and bush.
Is that what you always say?
Well, yeah, nearly always. Given time, I can come up with things really pretty bad. Would you give me some time?
I'd love to, but I have a date.
Oh. Well, as I also always say, if at first you don't succeed, quit.
No, I don't think that's a very good saying.
Yeah, it isn't. I wish I could think of a better one.
Well, how about may I phone you the next time I'm in London?
Now, that's what I call a saying. Yeah, may I phone you the next time I'm in London?
You certainly may. I work at the Admiralty. Second Officer Emma Jeffries.
Emma Jeffries. Emma, I'm being transferred to the Pacific. I may not be able to phone for a month or two. Do you like to get letters?
Love to.
Well, if you get one from a Lieutenant Commander Richard Browning, would you answer it?
I'm sure I would. Now, if you go straight down there and turn right at the end, you'll come to Waterloo Bridge, and the station's just across the other side of it.
It's still pretty foggy, Fred. Wouldn't you like to show me the way?
Well, I'd love to, but I don't think it would be fair to my date.
Well, what about being fair to me?
Well, phone me and I will be.
I like your style, Fred. I'll phone.
I'm glad. Goodbye, Commander. Good luck. I'm sorry I'm late. I got stuck in the fog. Oh, it's terrible out there.
Dick couldn't wait. He said to apologize.
Oh, what a shame.
Can I get you a drink?
Yes, please. I'll have a small gin and lime.
I guess anybody who wasn't here in the 40s would find it hard to imagine what it was like during the war.
Well, there was a lot of sadness and sacrifice. But there were lighter moments, too. I remember there was an old Cockney couple who lived next door to us, and one night when the air raid siren went off, we were all dashing down into the underground, and the lady suddenly said, "Here, Bert, I forgot me false teeth." And he yelled back, "Well, what do you think they're bloody dropping, sandwiches?" Anyway, we made it to the shelter all right, and my mum and dad were there, and they sang, and I sang, and everybody joined in. It was fun.
What kind of song did you sing?
Oh, you know, all the favorites of the day.
I'd love to hear one.
We'll meet again. Don't know where, don't know when. But I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Just like you always do, till the blue skies chase the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know?
tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing. Again, don't know where, don't know where. But I know we'll meet again some sunny.
Yes, we've done it all here, from the Ukrainian folk dancers to the classical Chinese theater.
What is that?
It's another one of the great theater art forms that at one time or another has played Drury Lane.
I'll bet you the burlesque never played Drury Lane.
Burlesque? What is this burlesque?
Ladies getting undressed on stage.
Went to see ladies getting undressed on stage?
Well, yeah, there is that, but I went to see the sketches.
Oh, sure.
Well, they had great ones like Flugel Street, Pay the $2, Slowly I Turn. They were classics, every one of them.
Doesn't sound very classic to me.
Well, in my country, burlesque was just as classic as your Chinese classical theater.
This Slowly I Turn, has it a plot?
Oh, yeah, it's about this depressed young girl who goes into a doctor's office.
Well, it's not Slowly. That's the famous classical Chinese sketch.
Empress needs services of humble physician?
Empress not in need. Empress need nothing. Have everything.
Oh.
Well, perhaps small need.
I listen.
I lie. Physician, I feel so depressed. Is difficult to speak?
Old proverbs say, he who speak with open heart find words to match.
Have confession to make.
Continue.
Confession as follows. Many years before Yan Ying Dynasty, I have lover. Lover also have lover.
Bad news.
My lover not tell me of his lover, till one day as sun falls and moon rises, my lover leave for lands far away. But lover never really leave for lands far away. Lover leave for other lover. I search for him days, weeks, months. Finally find him in Constantinople.
I can't stand how you spell that.
When I see him, all senses leave me.
I understand.
Empress not in control of emotions.
Cuckoo.
Emotions ruler must have revenge. Yes. Suddenly remember tricks taught me by old Kung Fu master.
Ah, we'll come back to you.
Lover standing in moonlight. Lover see me. Slowly I turn.
Slowly she
step
turns.
By step.
Step
I
by
reach
step.
For throat.
Reach for throat.
I choke. I squeeze. I pull. I shake.
You feel better now?
Yes, much, much better.
First, that's what we're here for.
Oh, really, so much better. Before I go, please accept token of gratitude.
Well, that's very gracious.
Priceless.
Oh, made in Constantinople.
Lover standing in moonlight. Lover see me. Slowly I turn.
Yes, you told me.
Step
that.
By step. I reach you. I choke. I squeeze. I pull.
Oh, Bert, just let it all out.
That was a new one. You feel better now?
Oh, yes. Very, very much better.
Oh. Then Empress cured. May God need not come back, ever.
Oh, I'm so grateful.
Good. Thank you so much for a lovely gift from Constantinople.
There was lover standing in moonlight. Lover see me, slowly I turn. Step by step, I reach
for
throat. I choke, I squeeze, I pull, I...
Considering retiring. You may go now.
Oh, thank you. It's a sad story I tell.
Very sad story. Very painful story. I am sorry I asked.
I did not speak of personal things, I hope.
No, just ordinary small talk.
Then I did not mention place called...
Cairo.
Cairo, but Cairo is in Egypt.
Close enough.
No, not Cairo. I would know name if I heard it.
Perhaps you will recall it when you leave.
Perhaps, maybe when I come back tomorrow.
No. Our physician has made decision. Consultation no longer needed.
You mean I am cured?
Yes. Yes, Empress cured of all ills.
Congratulations!
Oh, thought she was going to commit error again.
Error? Of what error you speak?
Why, unimportant. Just a word.
What word?
A word. A word is a word. Yes, hey, a word.
Any word?
Yeah, any word except Constantinople.
Lover standing in moonlight. Lover see me slowly.
Position also.
Oh, thank you so very much. I feel much, much better. I was so depressed when I came in.
That's what we're here for.
Physician, I'm so depressed.
Thank you.
And I would remind you, sir, that Drury Lane has managed to survive quite nicely for over 300 years without any help from the colonies. Am I not right, Miss Andrews?
No.
Lord, Julie.
A lot of wonderful American musicals have been big hits at Drury Lane.
Big hits? Bigger than The Humorous Lieutenant, The Silent Woman, The Maid's Tragedy, The Beggar's Bush? Oh, Julie.
I'm afraid so.
I suppose you're prepared to furnish examples to support this ridiculous claim?
Show them, Julie.
No more a smart little girl with no heart. I have found me a wonderful guy.
There is nothing you can do. There is anything
I can do. I am in the conventional dither with a conventional star in my eye. And you will note there's a lump in my throat when I speak of that wonderful guy. I must try him as gay as a daisy in May, a cliché coming true. I'm bromidic and bright as a moon, happy night pouring light on the dew.
There ain't a thing that's wrong with any man here that can't be good by putting him near a girly woman.
The flag on the 4th of July. If you'll excuse an expression I use, I'm in love, I'm in love.
There is nothing like a day.
I'm in love, I'm in love.
There is nothing like a day.
I'm in love.
Oh,
what a wonderful girl.
There is nothing like a day.
Chicks and ducks and geese better scurry when I take you out in the Surrey. When I take you out in the Surrey with the fringe on top.
Watch that fringe and see how it flutters when you drive them high step and strutters. Nosy folks will peek through the shutters and their eyes will pop.
The wheels are yellow, the upholstery's brown.
The dashboard's genuine leather.
With eyes and glass curtains you can roll right down in case there's a change in the weather. Two bright side lights winking and blinking. Ain't no finer rig I'm a-thinking.
You can't keep your rig if you think you better
do swap.
For that shiny little Surrey.
In that shiny little Surrey with the fringe
on the top.
Yeah.
long for you. Painting a picture or two.
But if when you hear I'm gonna go and taste Saturday's high life.
Before the parade passes by, I'm gonna get some life back to my life.
I'm ready to move out in front. I've had enough of just passing by life.
With the rest of them, with the best of them, I can hold my head up high.
For I've got a goal again.
I've got a drive again.
I'm gonna feel my heart coming alive again
before the parade passes by.
I'm ready to move
out in front. I've had enough of just passing by life. When the whistles blow and the cymbals crash and the stars blur by the sky, I'm gonna raise the banner. I'm gonna carry on. Give me a movie. Give me an open time before the
Yes. Are you quite certain you're correct? I could have sworn that all of those shows were English.
I'm sorry, old buddy. All made in the good old USA. Every one of them.
Yes, well, there can be no disputing one theatrical contribution that is totally English.
And that would be?
Tea.
Ah.
Tea? What does that have to do with show business?
My dear man, without tea, there would never have been the felt slipper, as it was originally called, or, as you Americans refer to it, as the old soft shoe.
The soft shoe? I suppose you're prepared to offer examples in support of this ridiculous claim?
Show it, Ghost.
I'm discontented with homes that are rented, so I have invented my own.
Darling, this place is a lover's oasis where life's weary chases are known.
Far from the cry of the city, where flowers pretty caress the stream. Cozy to hide in, to live side by side in,
don't let it abide in your dreams.
Picture you upon my knee, just tea for two and two for tea, just me for you and you for me alone.
Nobody near us to see us or hear us. No friends or relations on weekend vacations. We won't have it known, dear, that we own a telephone.
Dear,
day will break and I'll awake and start to bake a sugar cake for you to take for all the boys to see.
We will raise a family,
a boy for you,
a girl for me.
Can't you see how happy we could be?
For a 300-year-old ghost, you get around pretty good.
That's very decent of you, old chap. Thank you, thank you. Oh, no, go on, go ahead.
Go ahead and what?
Go ahead. You've been dying to put your hand through me, haven't you? Go ahead, go ahead. I don't mind.
Well,
go on, go on.
Okay, I will. God, thanks a lot.
We have to leave you now, dear ghost. We had a lovely time.
That's right. I don't suppose we'll be seeing you again.
Can't be too sure of that. Nothing's final. Not even death and taxes. I've managed to survive both.
You know, I left a coat around here somewhere.
Here we are, love.
Oh, thank you. Goodbye.
Well,
bye.
So long, Elk.
See you later, Charlie.
Not to be. I must be getting better.